to this celebration of my mother, Nancy Goldberg, the Belvoir Experience, and the Edna Y. Schwartz Scholarship Program. Nancy, Belvoir, and the Scholarship Program all share the same goals: to help young women learn about themselves through the study of the arts and community living. This amazing turnout is proof of the importance of that goal, the importance of the work that my mother does every day, and the life-changing effects of a Belvoir summer. In this busy, hectic, and often difficult world, Nancy, Belvoir, and the Scholarship Program continue to make an important contribution. Thank you for coming and helping us with this significant work. I feel fortunate to work with my mother and to work with all the campers and the staff to make each summer a magical experience. Enjoy the show, which is contributed by friends, and I look forward to welcoming you personally at the post-concert party. Fortunately, this event was sponsored by some generous Belvoir families, so thank you to them and to all of you for being here tonight. One reminder, no flash photography, and please turn all cell phones off. Thank you and enjoy the show.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We are the Can-Do Band. We're here tonight to honor one of the greatest benefactors of musicians with Williams Syndrome, Nancy Goldberg. Most of us first found each other at that magical musical place called Belvoir Terrace, thanks to Nancy.
Nancy helped to nourish the seed of the dream that grew into the Berkshire Hills Music Academy, where all the Can-Do Band members developed into more mature musicians. Tonight, Nancy, we are singing and playing our hearts out for you. You've been there for us time after time.
Thank you. take this opportunity to introduce the members of the Candy Band to you tonight. Tori Ackley on keyboards and vocals. Kevin LeVue on drums and guitar. Robbie Belknap on bass and trumpet. John Libera on clarinet and saxophone. Jeff Fleming on drums and vocals. And my name is Lucas Wall and I play guitar. Thank you.
Nancy, we are delighted to be here to celebrate your birthday. We wouldn't be here where we are without your vision and support. This song is for you. We love you.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Raven Barkley, and I was a camper for 2 years. My cottage year was 2009. But first of all, I would like to say that I'm so honored to be here tonight to celebrate Nancy's birthday. And attending Belvoir was the highlight of my life because I was able to meet great people and build lifelong relationships. It was here where I met Nancy, who has become a great mentor for me. But I remember when I first met Nancy, she told me that I would love this camp because the camp color was purple, and my favorite color is purple. And she was right. I loved Belvoir from the first day I arrived, and I still love Belvoir to this day. And I always will have the purple-itis. Thank you.
Thank you. Imaginations create greatness. Before money is raised or space is acquired, before staffs are assembled and business structured, somebody asks what if, and then something beautiful is born. In this special case, an amazing fine arts camp. This what if is the primary question, the one that has brought thousands of schools into existence in America, including the founding of one in Lenox, Massachusetts 56 years ago. It is a question that entrepreneurs come back to even after the buildings are built, the camper brochure mailed, the donations requested, and the students arrive. What if precedes everything? That what if pushes the camp community to a new and exciting realm. What if a camp truly represents the needs of young women in the fine and performing arts? An artistic community where it is not only possible but essential to do theater as diverse as August Osage County, the Secret Garden, and Exit the King. A community filled with young people whose musical idiom is equally diverse and love composers from Bach to Mozart, Debussy to Weill, holding court in their own imagination. A community where its dance theater not only entertains but enlightens through a steady exploration of ballet, modern, and jazz. Belvoir is at its best when it speaks to the human spirit through the arts as tactile as sculpture and as fleeting as a song. Tonight, we honor a truly fearless hero, Nancy Goldberg. A hero who stands on the educational stage, exposed to a dark void out there where there is no art. And champions for those who desire to learn and those who love to teach. She nurtures and supports those people who risk so much through each step of their process in unlocking their I am. The first human experience is an I am. Consciousness gives way to identity and limitations. I am a director. I am a husband. I am a father. I am a son. I am a progressive liberal. And I'm a gaming geek. But Nancy helps us see the empty space after the phrase, I am. The individual has unlimited power of belief. I am anyone. I am everyone. I am all. I am the universe. It is the optimistic power of the possible. And our beloved mentor helps us to tap into that awesome force and bring light to a darkened room. Nancy, all of us share our admiration for your visionary imagination and resolute servant leadership. And I will cherish our enduring friendship forever. And thank you for the transformative effect that you've had on my life, as well as everyone I know. We love you. Happy birthday.
Thank you. It's taken all my courage to approach you, not to mention all my stamina to follow you across the hills and deserts. But I feel as if I'm ready to confess to you the feelings that I've hidden with great diligence and labor behind the facade of your odd little next door neighbor. My eyes are too small. I've got very large feet, and I'm not very proud of my pitiful tweet. But I've now got a tail that is something to see. Oh, notice me, Horton, feather by feather. This is your next door neighbor calling. Notice me, Horton, Horton, together we could be great. Oh, notice me, Horton, put down the clover. This is your next
bunks upstairs in the dining room, and we were in the front circle, and Nancy saw us from across the way, and she came running over, and she introduced herself to the parents, and she said, when Deborah first came to camp, she thought she was a dancer. She wasn't. But she became a tennis star, right? Well, I just stood there and I was a little embarrassed and I was like, yeah, Nancy, that's right. I wasn't a dancer. You were very right about that. My athletic abilities were a bit questionable as well. But basically, Nancy guided me and told me to take other classes, and I discovered a whole new side of me. That I have Nancy to thank for that. But all joking aside, Nancy Goldberg is a person that I can turn to when I need advice or support or the simple, honest truth. Because she tells it like it is, for better or for worse. But I've always found that it's for the best. Anytime you want to, you can come back here. All you have to do is shut your eyes. Days and weeks of laughter will come rushing back. You'll find yourself at Belvoir, no matter where we go.
big we grow, the plays we wrote, the songs we sang, the games we played, the bells we rang and rang and rang. Anytime you want to, you can come back here. All you have to do is close your eyes. Days and weeks of laughter will come rushing back. You'll find yourself at Belvoir. Tea.
Thank you everyone for coming tonight, and happy birthday, Mom. Nancy wanted me to tell you a story, and she printed this up for me. So, Diane and I are musicians because of Belvoir Terrace. The first time I heard a violinist was when I was 3, and I attended a concert in the barn, which is now the lodge, at camp. And the camper who was playing was Jill Levy, who was 10 at the time, and she was also interested in dancing, and she went on to become a professional violinist. But I remember after I heard that concert, I went back to the cottage, which at that time was our family home, and we had no campers living there. And I told Nancy I wanted to play the violin. So I started learning, and I've been playing ever since. And Edna created a place that is not only fun and happy for young women, but is also educational and life-changing. I am fortunate to be working at camp with today's campers, and passing on all the things I've learned, and also working to create an audience for future generations. My daughter Sophia also benefits from camp, where she enjoys visual arts, music, and swimming, and having the social life with all the other girls. It is a pleasure for Diane and I to play the first movement of Beethoven's Kreutzer Sonata for Nancy and for everyone else together.
Thank you. Madison Charney, and I am going to close out the program. Only a brave Belvoir girl would follow the list. And Nancy did not tell me what to say. So I could talk about how she changed my life and about how she was the first person after my own mother who realized I was a singer. But instead, I think it's very important for you to know that in the summer of 1981, Nancy decided that I would most definitely not be a synchronized swimmer. I'm going to sing a few things for you tonight, none of which are on the program. The first is an aria from an opera called Adriana Lecouvreur by Chilea. And the important thing to know about this aria is that it is about the experience of being a singer, of being an artist, of being a human, and dealing with the hand you've been dealt with as much grace and humility as you possibly can. And since Nancy really was, after Nancy, my mother, who's right there, I can hear her cough. Since she really was the first person after my own mother to know that I would be a singer, I thought it was appropriate to sing for her and for you a piece about what it means to be a singer.
Thank you.
Oh.
I'm not such a good speechwriter, but somehow it came out all right. I want to thank you all for coming. This party is not for me alone, but for Edna and Belvoir. And all the campers and staff that have contributed to each summer. I feel very blessed by my family and your friendship and the opportunities Edna gave me and all the Belvoir women to grow through the arts and through community. I want to thank everyone for helping me to learn and grow. The exciting experience of camp and working on camp has helped me to become a better person. I'm much better now than I was when some of you were there. Opportunity is shared by the campers and the staff. I look forward to summer 2011 and to the challenges that it will certainly provide. At camp, we take the opportunity to improve ourselves and our world. We try to make a difference. I invite you all to join us in this exciting adventure. Come back to Alumni Day, support the scholarship program, stay in touch with us and your Belvoir friends, and above all, be the best person you can. Be a true Belvoir girl and woman. Thank you for the people, especially for the people who helped to support this party, and thank you very much for coming. And what's going to happen now? I'm very good at doing that. I've done it a few times. What's going to happen now is that we're going to leave through this door to my right and into the party space. And in the party space, there's a few tables with lists of who's here. So if you want to check and see who's here, you can look at those lists. And there's going to be some slide projections, some old pictures, and some more recent pictures. You can see your mother. She was your age. You can see my girls when they were first playing their instruments. And it should be really fun to see the pictures. And you can have lots of good things to eat, and later some birthday cake. And so I want you, it's very steep here, so people be careful when they're coming down. And the people on the front go first. And the coats are going to be downstairs at the end of the party, and there's also a gift when you leave.